Hello students, good morning. Today we will continue with the elegy written in a country churchyard. We have read its first three stanzas. Now we will continue with fourth stanza. I will read it out for you. Beneath those rugged elms and yew trees said, where heaves the turf in many a mouldering heap, each in his narrow cell for ever laid the rude forefathers of the hamlet sleep. This stanza is all one long sentence, and the sentence structure is a bit wacky because the subject and the verb of the sentence are way down there in the last line of the stanza, where we can say the word rude forefathers is used and as a subject, and the sleep is for verb. Here the word rude is not used to describe them as impolite, but for the person who is from a tiny village which we call hamlet, someone who was not sophisticated. So the forefathers being described here are probably just simple country folks, not discourteous, impolite people. So what are these country forefathers of the hamlet doing? They are sleeping peacefully, right? Look at the third line. They are not sleeping in their beds. They are sleeping in narrow cells, and they are laid in there forever. Sounds like they are sleeping in only a metaphorical sense. These guys are dead and lying in their graves in the churchyard. The first two lines of the poem set in the scene, these graves are under elm and yew trees. Elm trees, in Hindi we can say it is the tree of Chirabel, and the yew trees means evergreen trees, and there are piles of turf on each one. Turf means grass. So we are not just hanging out outside of a church as the sun goes down, we are actually hanging out in the graveyard. Okay. Now we will move on our fifth stanza. If you had not figured it out from the previous stanza, the speaker wants to clarify that the sleeping guys are not going to wake up. The first three lines of the stanza list different things that normally would wake a person up. The first one is delicious smell of the breeze in the morning. Here the word incense is used. What is incense? Incense is a substance that you burn to make a room smell good. The second thing is the twittering and singing of the birds in their straw nests. And the last third one is the rooster's clarion alarm. Rooster means cock, male cock, or the echoes of a horn blown by a hunter or a shepherd. Having listed all those things in the first three lines, the speaker tells us that none of those things are going to wake up the dead guys anymore because they are dead. And you know, dead persons don't wake up. Now we will move on our stanza number 6th. Now in this stanza, the speaker is listing the kinds of day-to-day pleasures that these dead guys in the graveyard are not going to get to enjoy anymore. The first one is, no one is burning the hearth fire for them anymore, means no one is now cooking food for them. The second one, no housewife is trying to take care of him after he gets home from work in the evening. The third one is, no little kids are yelling, "Daddy's home." Here, the word lisp is used for not to enunciate clearly, and the word sir means father. No little kids climb. The fourth one is, no little kids climb up on his lap for kisses that would make their siblings envy of him. Now we will move on our stanza number 7th. Now the speaker imagines the kind of things these guys did back when they were still alive. They often harvested their crops with their sickles. The word sickle is used for a curved knife by which a farmer cuts his crops. More farmer language is used here in this line. A furrow is a long, narrow, shallow hole that you drop seeds into it. The next word is glebe. Glebe is an archaic word for farmland. Farmer would cut the furrow into the glebe using a plow to make or to grow seeds. Here the word stubborn is also used. Stubborn means hard. In this stanza, the speaker imagines that the farmer were cheerful or jocund as they drove their teams of oxen into the fields to plow. In the last line, the woods bobbed to the stroke of their axes as they cleared forest to make their farms. Okay, students, we will read out our next stanza and the rest of the poem in next video. Thank you.